After the abrogation of Article 370, we are also going to have reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh in the form of union territories after 31st of October. Till the time they revert back to the state as been on, declared by the Honorable Home Minister. Now, with the 370 having gone, we would by and large try to follow the models applicable in the other parts of the country as far, and they are still working out the nitty-gritties and modalities, but broadly speaking, I think the industries will have an opportunity to make investments. Of course, as far as domicile laws are concerned, they might, you know, have to be worked out, as are in other parts of the country.
What about the development come at a cost of destroying nature sometimes? So are there going to be some natural conservation laws that are going to be applicable in?
Yes, of course, that is obvious. That is done in every part of the country. That we've done in Northeast also and in other states also. But what was proving to be an impediment was all the education institutions, particularly the professional colleges like AIIMS, medical colleges, were devoid of faculty, because nobody would be willing to serve in an area or a territory where they would be deprived of having a living house or deprived of getting education facility for their children. So this was rather a disincentive instead of incentive to them. So A, the education institution, B, the healthcare had suffered a lot. We have a number of hospitals which are more of buildings rather than medical care. And C, as you mentioned, the industry and the business investment, if we can have in Northeast, because if you have seen what has happened in the last 5 years, we have investments even from distant places, from Israel, from Japan, and we started a startup program for Northeast, which is now attracting from startup groups from Gujarat and Karnataka. So if we could do that in a region which has far more constraints compared to Jammu and Kashmir, why can't we replicate these success stories? So I think, to my understanding, the answer is that it is Article 370, which not only proved an impediment in development, but also, in fact, may I say so, provided a fodder for terrorism to flourish, because you had placed the youth in a state of isolation where their mindset was vulnerable to all kinds of evil manipulations.